welcome to this brand new series. This is so exciting. This is a solo trip to Disneyland Paris. I'm currently in Manchester Airport, about to board my flight. It's been a very early start this morning. I got up around 4:30, it's 7 o'clock now. I think my gate's just opened, so I'm gonna head over there in a second. But yeah, there is a lot going on in this series. I'm going to a new Disneyland Hotel, well, the reopening of the Disneyland Hotel for the Royal Banquet character dining. I've also got character dining for the Plaza Garden for the breakfast. And yeah, we're going to see what else we can get up to. It's very exciting. So far, not too bad on the solo side of things. I've got a few flights on my own in the past, so I'm used to this side of things. I think it's going to be more throughout the day, not having someone to talk to all day is going to be strange. Obviously, I'm going to have the camera, which is going to help a lot. But yeah, I'll keep you updated on what the solo trip vibes are like throughout. So yeah, stick around, and it's going to be a great series. This is one advantage of solo traveling. I'd be normally waiting in that with Zoe, because she'd be telling me to get up and wait. But instead, I've decided to just sit here until I have to get up. So there you go, pro number one. Finally in Hotel Santa Fe. Whew, I've just checked in, give my bags over to the baggage area over there. Reception is that area up there. Just about to trip up in the car park. Oh my goodness, but here we are. So I can either walk over to Disney or I can get a bus. I think because I've been sat down for most of today so far, I think I'm going to get the bus. I think I'm going to walk. I don't, however, have a clue where I'm going. It's literally midday now, so I guess this is the point where we head into the parks. Let's do this. So straight away, I'm getting sort of Coronado Springs vibes, which makes sense. This is kind of a budget version, or a value resort version, I guess, of Coronado. Yeah, it's really nice, actually. I imagine this is quite a nice place just to, you know, have a wander around. And you can see just there is Hotel Cheyenne, just across the water. I really like the look of Hotel Cheyenne. Really like the Woody's Roundup themed rooms and just the general aesthetic, I guess, of it. So hopefully, maybe next time, we'll stay over there. I chose Santa Fe this time purely on the basis of it was incredibly cheap to stay here this week. So that's why I'm here. So I don't know if this is just because I'm in the Disney bubble and everything's perfect when you're in the Disney bubble, as you all know, but actually this is a really nice walk. This is, you know, it's really peaceful, it's really chilled out. You know, I'm now walking past, I think it's like the back end of Sequoia Lodge, I think. Part of me wonders if I should have crossed the one of the bridges over to the other side, but you know, we live and learn. We're doing this for the first time, so who knows if this is the right thing to do or not. I'm also hoping and praying that the stabilization on this camera has improved. I've changed a few settings. I've also got a mini tripod, should I say, that I'm holding to sort of help with that as well. And yeah, hopefully it's not as bad as when we were in Walt Disney World, but we'll see. If it is, then I apologise. I'll probably get a different bit of kit that I've got my eye on if I do think this footage looks rubbish. But we'll see. And ooh, I don't know if you're going to be able to see this on the camera, but just through these trees we can just about see the hotel of the Marvel Hotel, the Art of Marvel. So yeah, this was literally like, what, 10 minutes, if that. I think they say it's a 20 minute walk, so I guess it is, probably is a 20 minute walk into Disney. But, you know, 10 minutes to the village, not bad at all. Right, let's get in to Disney.
Here we are,
in the Disney village. This is the brand new restaurant, Rosalie. This is like French cuisine. I heard a lot of good things about here. Really want to try it at some point. They do French onion soup, and I really, really am craving French onion soup. Definitely going to make a stop, in Earl of Sandwich as well. Maybe tonight? I don't really know. I think it's going to be one of these two places tonight, after the fireworks. Let's see what we feel like, if we feel like a sit-down meal, or if we just want to grab something to take back to the room. And just like that, we are in Disneyland Paris. Oh my goodness, I'm very giddy right now. Oh, it's very exciting. It's very strange because, you know, it was only, what, 10 months ago I was here last? So it's not actually been that long. And this trip couldn't have come sooner. Oh my days. You might not be able to see the castle very well from there, but it's there, I promise. Oh my goodness. Oh, what a day. I love it. Main Street. And Pooh Bear right down there, meeting and greeting. Line is always crazy. So, if I want to meet Pooh, don't really know when is best to do that. I might try and do extra magic time, see, because I know he doesn't meet during that time, but if I could queue, you know, around then maybe the queue wouldn't be as long. I don't know. Maybe that's just wishful thinking. I love it. Oh my days. I've not really got a proper plan for today. I would like to do a couple of rides. Definitely want to see the fireworks and the drone show tonight, just because I feel like with Paris you need to watch it, or plan to watch it most nights, just in case, because you never know what might happen with weather conditions and all that stuff. So yeah, but for now I'm going to try and find some food, I think, and then yeah, we'll see what else we can do. I absolutely love these things. I don't know how long they're going to be in the parks for, because there's a few of them missing, I've noticed. Like the Winnie the Pooh one's not there, and a couple of others. So I do have to wonder how much longer they've got, because they were here for the 30th, and yeah, I do wonder if they're going to go away very, very soon. That's okay, because these things have to change. I do really like this one. With the fairies. And then there's the genie. Okay, I'm actually heading into Adventureland first, which I don't think I've ever done in Disneyland Paris. This is mainly because I want to head for some Mickey pizza, because I think that's what I want for lunch. But yeah, can't say I've ever come into here first. I'm normally first land on the left, which in this Sparks case is Frontierland. Right, I know it's in the, is it like Jungle Book themed? It's like Colonel something, Colonel Hattie, is it? Is that his name? Who knows? I know that it's, they sell it there anyway, so I've got a, and I know it's in Adventureland somewhere. Right, we're here. Colonel Hattie's, I assume that's how you say it. Let's go get ourselves some Mickey pizza. So the Mickey pizza is actually not that bad. I've heard mixed things. For 17 quid for a pizza, a garlic bread and a drink, it's not too bad really. 17 euros. Did I say euros? Not dollars or pounds. 17 euros. I don't know what the theme is to this restaurant, because obviously it's Colonel Hattie, but there's a lot of pictures of like maybe explorers on the walls. Who knows? Let me know if you know. Okay, food was pretty good. That pizza's a lot better than I thought. Everyone's like, you know, hit and miss about it, but I was a fan. Enjoyed it. Right, I think this is a queue for Chip and Dale that we're walking past here. Yeah, I can see Chip and Dale at the front of the line. Just there. There we go. I don't know what characters I want to meet, to be honest, because I'm doing two character dining experiences. I don't know which other characters I want to try and meet. Right, now, I think we may be too late for it, but the Lion King show is about to start in 15 minutes. I might be too late for getting in, but I thought I might as well come and try to get in. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work out. We've still got plenty of time, but being that I was right next to it, I thought I'd walk over here and try and go see that. Okay, looks like we're getting in. Why is the Lion King show in the Frontier Theatre? I guess there's no Adventureland Theatre, but it feels kind of wrong being in the Frontier Theatre.
Suffice like it's true.
Wow. Wow, wow. Wow, wow, wow. That was amazing. Blew my expectations out of the water there. Really enjoyed that one. So much better than I thought. I thought, you know, Festival of the Lion King at Animal Kingdom's great. I thought, past couple of times I've been here, I thought, I'm not gonna bother. I've seen that kind of thing. It's in Walt Disney World. But actually, it's different, but it's arguably, I mean, it's definitely arguably, I think I prefer it. I think it's better. I might be wrong. It might just because I quite like the huge scale of it compared to the sort of the thing in the round in Festival of Lion King in Animal Kingdom, but both amazing. But yeah, definitely do not pass it up. If you go to Walt Disney World and think, oh, I see that a lot in Walt Disney World, no, you need to see it. So good. So this is one of the restaurants that I'm hoping to come to later in the week. Casa de Coco. So they do like burritos and fajitas, all that kind of stuff. And oh, look at that. What an amazing gold statue of Miguel. Amazing. So I don't think, I mean, I might have just like completely missed it, but I feel like that wasn't there last time we were here, because we rode Big Thunder Mountain. It's literally here. definitely rode that last time. And yet, I don't remember riding or seeing the Coco restaurant. Admittedly, we didn't really, like, we planned most of where we were going for that. So, we weren't really thinking about food. But yeah, right, I think we've not yet done an attraction. So we've done food, done a show. But I want to keep the tradition going, I guess. I want to go and ride Phantom Manor to be the first ride that I go on in Disneyland Paris. Happened last time. It was the first and last ride we did last time. So I want to keep that tradition going. And what I love about this one is that it is, in fact, in Frontierland. It's perfectly themed. The area is so good. I think that's one of the things that they just nailed when they built parks this time. Because I feel like Animal Kingdom was built around the time this was built, and that park is beautiful. This park is beautiful. And yeah, right, let's go ride Phantom Manor. There it is, Phantom Manor. Amazing. And it looks like there's a character meet here. Is that Phantom Mickey? Is Phantom Mickey back? I hope so. I'd like, quite like to meet Phantom Mickey, if possible. Oh, it is. It's so good. So good, the facade of this ride. Right. 5 minute wait. I will take that any day of the week. In fact, I might even ride it twice for 5 minutes. I kind of want to know who's meeting down there. It's got to be Phantom Mickey, surely. I don't know anyone else who does meet there other than Jack and Sally during Halloween. Surely it's not them. They've been here a long time. If they're still here in January. Man. I don't know what it is about this ride. I don't know if it's like high capacity or something. But it's always got a low weight. So I don't think I've ever seen it more than 20 minutes. But for a ride that I very much enjoy, I'm not going to complain. To meet you.
And just like that, the Molly Brown is about to leave, so I thought, why not? I've never been on the Molly Brown, so let's go do this. I tell you what, this is a fantastic way to get to see more of Big Thunder by riding the Molly Brown. Not quite as prestigious as the Disney ducks on this little island. There's some, I don't know if you can see them, there's some Disney penguins, pigeons. So, that's the Molly Brown. That's a lot of fun. Definitely recommend it. So relaxing, so chilled. You get some great shots of Thunder Mountain and some great shots of Phantom Manor as well. So highly recommend it if you're into your photography or just you want some decent Instagram pictures. It's really nice and really relaxing. Highly, highly recommend. I wanted to do that for a while now, so I'm really glad I've ticked that off my list. So, right, I'm gonna go and have a wander around some shops, I think. So let's go see how that goes. Okay, so I'm just in the Frontier shop. So, Frontierland shop, and this is a great place. They've got loads of I've not been in the Emporium, but they've got a lot of unique merch, like this Big Thunder Mountain. They've got loads of stuff specific to the rides around here, so loads of, like, you can see all the Big Thunder Mountain stuff. I think that shirt was 35, by the way. So the Big Thunder Mountain Spirit jersey. Oh my days, look at that. That's so cool. I really like that. That's very tempting. Where's the... it is, I'm guessing 90. Oh, it's 80. Okay. So that's 80. And you get the Big Thunder Mountain ears as well. And you can even get a Big Thunder Mountain train. which is really cool. That's €150. This is more Big Thunder Mountain stuff. You can get the gold, piece of gold from Big Thunder. What else? Oh, they've got like a stack King mugs. So they've got Phantom Manor, Big Thunder, Hollywood Studio, Tower of Terror, sorry, and Pirates. And that's quite fun. That's 35. Seems like the theme. Oh dear. The theme of it is 35 around here. And here's the Phantom Manor one. I'm going to go into the light because you can't really see this very well. So there's the Phantom Manor one. And the back of it looks very cool. Really like that. I think that one's going to be 80 again. Yep, 80. I'm a fan. I kind of want one of these. They're really nice. Oh, sorry. These are 25, so that's not too bad actually for a Big Thunder Mountain top. That's quite nice. I'm tempted. I don't normally wear like cream or white shirts, but it's very, very tempting. Let's have a look at this Phantom Manor stuff. So again, you can't really see this, but it's a Phantom Manor light sign, which is very impressive. That's €120. You've got the spirit jersey again. Oh, you've got like a portrait of the Phantom, I think, I presume. Henry Ravenswood. Is he the Phantom? Who knows? Maybe you do. Let me know. and then cheaper stuff. So, I mean, these are still $10, €10. This is quite a nice magnet, though. That's £9. So that isn't... it's not too bad, I guess. Okay, we've got the focus back. And there's a glow-in-the-dark Phantom Manor shirt, that's also 26. Random prices. Now I'm looking at all the prices, that's 26, the other one's 25. Oh, they've got a lounge fly to go with that. Oh my days, this is so funny. You can get the singing busts. So, I don't know what you'd do with them, but that's kind of hilarious. How much are they? They are €49. So if you've got a plan for them, then go for it. This is something I'm going to be getting. This is the attractions artwork. So I love these posters. I think they're beautiful. And there's loads of them. And these are the ones that you see on Main Street. So in most, if not all, Disney parks on Main Street, they have them somewhere on display, I believe. And these are like the Paris specific ones. So they're very nice. They're 35, I think. There's a huge 70% off sale over here, and it's mainly got like the Disney 100 stuff. So whether it's like the 100 decade stuff, which I'll very briefly show over here, so like the 100 decade, that kind of stuff over there, or like some of the new, some of the lounge flies they bought out. There's loads, there's so much over there. So yeah, it's very exciting that this is like on sale, to be honest, because it's, however, it is making me very tempted to buy stuff. And I don't know, I don't want to do it, because like these are normally 45, and because they're 45, they are now £13.50, which is crazy. There's a Kronk Funko Pop, which surely this, if this is 10, oh man, why is that 30? Why is that €30? What happened to Funko? I thought they used to be cheap. But yeah, there's loads of stuff on sale. I don't know how often they do this, but it's worth coming in here and checking it out, just in case it's... Well, just in case they always do a sale in here. Who knows? I didn't. Okay, so I may come to regret it, but I have walked away empty-handed. There's lots of good deals in there. Very, very tempting. But I'm going to do the classic thing of have a think about it and then go back and there'll be nothing there, so that's okay. Oh look, it's the genie. Just wandering through Adventureland. And the classic, people running after him.
Thank you.
our small world is so iconic. I love it. It's been a long time since I wrote that version, but it's great. Love it. In order for it to stick about, though, I do feel like they might need the Disney characters in there soon. And to be fair, I think this one fits it better than the other, than the Disney World one, just because there's a lot more things that you can obviously see. Like, there's a literal genie in there. There's a guy on a flying carpet. There's I can't even think what else. There's someone on a surfboard. Like, there's characters in there. You can obviously see, you know, where the Aladdin characters could go. You can see Lilo and Stitch on the surfboard. I don't know. I'd be up for it. I love sticking Disney in any ride, to be honest. I'm not against it. So, and not any ride, by the way. Not any ride. But yeah, I think it would be great if they did that one day. But who knows? I love it how it is, but when it's constantly got a 5-minute wait, that kind of shows how popular the ride is. I know that there's always a lot of boats, so that is another reason. Big capacity ride, but yeah. Let's bring the Disney characters into that. That'd be great. Right, now I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm very tempted with Pirates because it was a 10-minute wait a minute ago. Let me just check if that's still the case. Nothing's wanted to come up on my app. Oh, it's now a 5-minute wait. Should we wander over? Hope that it's not got any worse than that, because, you know, 5 minutes would be ideal. And then after that, I think I might be done for rides, you know. I might just have a wander around, hopefully see the parade. It's not due, it's like, according to the weather, it's not supposed to rain whilst we're here. Whilst I'm here, not we. Not the royal we. Yeah, it's not supposed to rain, but it feels like it's supposed to be cloudy all 4 days I'm here. But this weather at the moment is not giving me much hope for that actually to happen. So, but we'll see. Right, let's head to Pirates. Pirates of the Caribbean, that's what we like to see. 5-minute wait. Yes, please. Still want to stay there. And there's Captain Jack's. Still want to eat there one day. But it's not going to happen on this trip, unfortunately. I think it'd be so cool to eat there one day, though. And in the Pirates shop, they've got a Pirates of the Caribbean spirit jersey. That's very cool. I really love the attraction spirit jerseys they've got going. And just like the general merch is 100 times better than April last year, which is crazy, because that's not that long ago, and yet... Sorry, the battery died then. Yeah, I was saying just the merch in general, it's just 10 times better, 100 times better than it was last year. These are great. Pirates of the Caribbean themed hats. I mean, there's loads of t-shirts. I like these, like, these are like lunch bags, aren't they? And it feels like it's like a, got that feel and that look of like a map. Yeah, I bet there'll be like a cooler bag kind of The inside, yeah, they're ace. I really like that. I don't need one, but how much are they? 25. So what a cool lunchbox that'd be. Ooh, I do like this. Do like a zipped hoodie. I am a fan of a zipped hoodie. What's on the back? The back sells it for me. I'm not sure. Oh, I quite like that though, because it's stitched. It's a lot nicer than like these ones that are just printed on the back. How much is that? That's very tempting. Can I see the price? Let's try and find the price on a different one. Price for that is $50, 50 euros, sorry. So I don't think I'm gonna ever remember that it's euros and not dollars. That's very tempting. I don't know what to get anymore. I've got money for merch. I've got a little space in my case for merch, but I have no idea what I want anymore. It's tricky. Loads and loads of like pirate themed stuff, as you'd expect. Oh, this is cool. I like that. I really like that. Oh, it's a Traditions. I didn't realise that. It says 120 quid. Jim Shaw. So, not quite my name, but it also is my name. Jim Shaw makes these. Very cool. I'm a fan. Right. I think we're getting less pirates, more Nightmare Before Christmas, which doesn't make a lot of sense, but that tells me that we've seen all the pirates merch. Right, let's head out. Absolutely one of my favourite rides. I love that ride. It's so good. I'll definitely be riding that at least once more during this trip. Is it my favourite here? It might be, you know. It's definitely in the top five, but I love it. Love, love, love Pirates of the Caribbean. Especially this one. So good. And then to come out of Pirates and then you're greeted with... I'm just getting in the way of people now. And you're just greeted by this, an actual pirate ship, and the school rock. Oh, it's so cool around here. I love it. Hello, it is Future Me with the outro for this video. Once again, a whole series where I've not really done any outros in the middle of the day. I probably should do that, but also I quite enjoyed doing this bit in the last series anyway, so... I may have intentionally not done any outros this time round for this series. Anyway, I'm rambling. So that is the end of this this first vlog. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. I talk a bit about meeting characters in this vlog. And it is incredible knowing what I know now, knowing that I met so many characters, filled this autograph book. It is going to be very exciting to see what's, you know, all the characters I meet. In the next episode, we watch the parade. Unfortunately, we don't quite manage to watch the drone show or the fireworks. I get a bit too tired. But we do have a bit of a Santa Fe room tour. We explore the resort a little bit, and then I just have a little chat, a bit like this one, at the end. So it's another great episode. Definitely look forward to that one. But yeah, I'm gonna stop talking now because I feel like I've talked loads. So hopefully you've enjoyed this one, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.